This is Evangelist Sean Pinder. How is everybody doing on tonight? Praise God, praise God. We serve an awesome God. Amen. Is anyone there? Hello, friends. Praise God. How are you guys doing on Periscope? We serve a mighty awesome God. I said we serve a mighty, mighty, awesome, awesome, awesome God who loves his people. He have awesome plans for your life. Amen. Hello, how are you guys doing? Praise God. Thanks for joining. We are talking about receiving the anointing of the Holy Ghost on tonight. Ah, you can tell I'm excited about this. I love teaching on the Holy Ghost. I said I love teaching on the Holy Ghost. What a mighty God we serve. God bless you, Mrs. Garcia, all the way in Fresno, California. Amen. We serve a good God. Are you guys excited about the Word of God on tonight? Are you guys excited about the Word of God on tonight? Welcome, friends. Welcome, welcome. How are you all doing on tonight? Praise God. Where are you calling in from? All right, Longview, Texas in the house. Praise God. I'm up here in Carrollton, Texas. Carlo from Chicago, welcome you guys. Yeah, we got people on Periscope on my phone all the way from London. God bless you, sis. And we got people on the conference call. Well, I'd just like to welcome all of you guys. I'm really excited. Do me a favor, you guys that's watching me through Periscope, share this broadcast with your friends and your followers right now, please. Just slide up if you're on an Android device, up or down, and invite your friends and your followers. If you're on an iPhone, swipe from right to left or left to right and share this with your friends. You can also tweet about it. Praise God. We're about to jump. We're going to jump into the Word of God in a few minutes. First, you know we got to open with prayer. Welcome. Welcome, friends. Amen. We're periscoping and we're doing the conference call at the same time. How are you doing there, friends, that's on the teleconference line? You're doing fine. Praise God. Are you guys expecting an impartation from the Holy Ghost on tonight? Come on, talk back to me. Are you guys on Periscope as well? Are you? Amen. That's what I'm talking about. Are you guys on Periscope expecting to receive an impartation from the Holy Ghost tonight? Listen, you know if I'm teaching on a topic called receiving the anointing, you know we believe in God for impartation to take place tonight. And every one of you that's on the broadcast, whether it's on the live teleconference line or on Periscope, you qualify tonight. I say you qualify. I say you qualify. You qualify tonight to receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. I'm going to share a lot from my heart. We're going into the scriptures, but I'm going to share a lot from my heart tonight because I want you guys to be able to tap into the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I want God to work in your life in a mighty way. Look, I'm not content just for me and my wife to be flowing. And there's a whole lot of people in the body of Christ flowing, but listen, amen. Listen, drive safe now, sis. Listen, friends, I am telling you, I want every single one of you guys that's on this live teleconference call and that's listening through Periscope, the Holy Spirit anointing, it belongs to you, friend. And what I'm going to share with you tonight is receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. A lot of you already position yourself to receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit. A lot of you already receiving the anointing of the Holy Ghost. So what God's going to do tonight on the teleconference call and through Periscope, he is going to reaffirm you and let you realize that you really have positioned yourself to receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Now, come on, friends. Let's open in prayer. You know we got to pray. Come on, saints. Let's pray. Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, God, we give you praise tonight. We give you glory tonight, oh God. We give you honor tonight. We magnify you. We magnify you tonight. Pour the Holy Ghost out on your people tonight. God, anoint these lips of clay. Let me speak under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Let me teach your people the Word of God. Under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, let a mighty impartation, let it take place tonight, God. God, let people's lives be changed. Let their situations supernaturally take a turn for the better, God. Where they were once weak, Let them become strong. You said in your word in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, that you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. We give you praise tonight. We give you glory tonight. We give you honor tonight, oh God. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We magnify you. Come on, saints, just open your mouth. Open your mouth and worship him right where you are. We bless you tonight, oh God. We adore you. We honor you, Lord Jesus. We are believing you tonight for a supernatural touch. Refresh your people. Revive your people in the name of Jesus. Shut down the attacks of the enemy tonight. I pray, God, that you give them supernatural revelation from the word of God. As we go into the scriptures tonight, God, we want to be changed. We don't want to be the same. We don't want to be the same, God. We don't just want to be ordinary Christians. We want to be Christians that turn the world upside down for Jesus. Use us in our generation. Use us like David said, God, I shall live and not die to declare the works of God to my generation. We bless you tonight. We honor you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God, praise God. Are you guys excited about God on tonight? Praise God. Praise God, you guys on the teleconference line. Are you excited about the word of God tonight? Oh, we serve a mighty, mighty God. Now listen, I really want to take my time with this because I want to lay a good, strong foundation. We're talking about something that's very important. We're talking about something that changed my life. So this topic I'm sharing with you tonight, I'm pouring my heart out to you guys because the anointing is not just for a few chosen people. The anointing of the Holy Spirit belongs to every child of God. If you are saved, if you've given your heart to Jesus, the anointing of the Holy Spirit belongs to you. Are you hearing me? Jesus said in Acts 1:8, he said, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost comes on you. You can't get power without the Holy Ghost. Are you hearing me? Some people nowadays are afraid of the Holy Ghost. They're afraid of the fire of God. Listen, we need the fire. I said, we need the fire. If we are going to convert this Gentile world and bring them to the foot of the cross, we need an outpouring of the Holy Ghost and fire. Listen, I believe in the fire of God. I believe in the power of God. I believe in preaching the gospel with signs, wonders, and miracles following. I believe in the move of the Holy Ghost. We got to have the move of God back in our lives. Without the moving of the Holy Ghost, we would dry up and be ineffective and go to our graves without fulfilling the call of God. But that devil is a liar tonight. I said, you shall receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Your life is not going to be the same. You are not just going to be an ordinary Christian. My God, when you get up out of bed in the morning, I said, when you get up out of bed in the morning, the demons and the devils are going to be nervous. They're going to say, oh my gosh, look who's about to get up out of that bed. This means trouble for us. Jesus said, upon this rock, I'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Me and you are the body of Christ. The Apostle Paul made a powerful statement in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 6. The Apostle Paul says, know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you? The Holy Ghost is in you, friend. Are you hearing me? But we're talking about the anointing of the Holy Spirit. It's the anointing of the Holy Spirit that changes an ordinary vessel and makes it extraordinary. Are you listening to me? Watch this. It was the anointing of the Holy Ghost on Jesus that took 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish and fed a multitude of men besides women and children. That means it was possible that it was over 25,000 people that ate from 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. And the Bible says they all were filled. You know what that means to fill 5,000 men besides women and children? The Bible says they were filled and they had leftovers. That's the kind of anointing I'm talking about. When Jesus stood before Lazarus's tomb and he said, take away the stone. My God, I tell you what, I believe the Holy Spirit's flowing right now. When he said, take away the stone, he said three words. He didn't pray no long prayer. Listen, when the anointing is on you, listen, there's a certain place in God and certain times you don't have to pray a long prayer. Are you hearing me? Like when Jesus went into the Garden of Gethsemane, he prayed a long prayer, but not before Lazarus' grave. He said, Father, I thank you that you hear me always. And after he said that, he gave the command of authority under the anointing of the Holy Ghost and said, Lazarus, come forth. Ah, my God. And the Bible says, he that was dead came forth bound hand and foot. My God. Some of your children may be dead, but when the Holy Ghost calls them, they got to come forth. Your husbands may be dead spiritually, but when the Holy Ghost calls them, they got to come forth. Are you listening to me? But it takes the anointing of the Holy Spirit to work signs, wonders, and miracles, because in and of yourself, you can do absolutely nothing. That's why the Bible says it's not by power, it's not by might, but it is by my Spirit, says the Lord God. That's why I wrote a book. The name of it is A Call to the Miraculous. In that book, I share exactly the steps that God led me to be able to receive the miracle working power of the Holy Ghost. Are you listening to me? I'm not trying to keep it a secret. I want every Christian, I want every child of God walking in the anointing. I'm not satisfied for just me and my wife and some other people in the body of Christ to see miracles. I want you to work miracles as well. And the Holy Spirit is going to put some keys in your hands tonight. Can somebody say a good amen right there? Praise God. Listen, if you have your Bible, I want us to go right into the book. I want us to go right into the book of 2 Kings chapter 2. This is one of my favorite chapters, talking about how Elijah received a double portion of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Who wants to receive a double portion? Who wants to receive a double portion of the anointing of the Holy Ghost? Don't limit God. I said, don't limit God. Now watch this. Let's go right into the book of 2 Kings chapter 2. My God, my God, my God, I'm excited tonight. I said, my God, I'm excited tonight. I'm excited tonight. Praise God. You know, listen, there's different levels to the anointing, you know. Listen, there are different levels to the anointing of the Holy Spirit. You may speak with tongues, but that don't mean you're going to see signs, wonders, and miracles. There are certain things you got to put into practice in your life. And listen, when you do it, trust me, that miracle working power of God will descend on your life and everything in your life would take a turn for the better. Listen, when the miracle anointing of the Holy Spirit, when that anointing for signs, wonders, and miracles come in your life, there's not going to be no denying. It's going to be no denying that the anointing of the Holy Spirit has touched down in your life. Because when that anointing comes, the same exact miracles that Jesus and the apostles saw that you read about in the Bible, those exact same miracles are going to take place in your life. Are you listening to me? Are you hearing what I'm talking about? Watch this. 2 Kings chapter 2 says this. And it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Listen, the word came to the prophets that, listen, God is getting ready to take the prophet away. God's getting ready to take your teacher back into heaven. Are you listening to me? And the Bible says, when Elisha got a hold that Elijah is about to leave, Elisha said, wait a minute, I'm not allowing this powerful man of God to go to heaven with this powerful anointing and leave me here like a natural man. I'm going to stick with this man of God until what's on him rubs off on my life. Listen, that's powerful what I said, because you got to realize this. One of the keys, I'm going to share everything. I'll try to share everything as much as I know. Kind of impossible in this one setting. Amen. Listen, one of the ways, are you ready for this? One of the ways to tap into the anointing of the Holy Spirit is by hanging around other anointed people of God. The anointing is transferred by association. Are you hearing me? If you hang around dead, dry folk, guess what, friends? You'll be dead and you'll dry up and you won't see nothing happen. But listen, you got to get around people that have already tapped into the, don't try to be a know-it-all, amen? I said get around people who are seeing real signs, wonders, and miracles happen. And guess what? As you continue to fellowship with those people. Listen, I'm in my flow now. The anointing of God's already flowing here. Listen, as you stay connected, like my brother is saying right here, as you stay around those kind of people, listen, and it doesn't have to be in the physical. You can tap into the anointing of a man or woman of God just by listening to their CDs, just by listening to their tapes, or even watching their broadcast. There's many different ways that you can receive the anointing. If every time you listen to certain men and women of God, you are captivated and you are just locked in the front of the screen and you feel as if you are plugged into a power. Guess what, friends? You have just found somebody that the Holy Spirit is going to flow through to anoint your life and to perform the same kind of miracles that's in that person's life. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Listen, let me share. I'm just going to pour my heart out to you guys. You know, after Samuel had anointed King Saul with oil, listen to what Samuel told Saul. This is in 1 Samuel chapter 9 and chapter 10. I'm just quoting. So if you want to get these scriptures, you may want to write them down and go look at them later. Samuel told Saul, he said, Saul, on your way back home, listen to these words good. You are going to meet a company of prophets. They're going to be playing their musical instruments. And Samuel said, when you get around those anointed prophets of God, that's worshiping God, that's magnifying God, that's lifting him high, Samuel said, Saul, the Spirit of God is going to come on you and you are going to prophesy. My God, are you listening to this? King Saul wasn't even a prophet. He was the king of Israel to lead God's people into battle. And guess what? The Bible says King Saul went and he met those companies. He met the company of prophets and they were worshiping God with their musical instruments. They were lifting him high, giving glory to God. And the Bible says the anointing of the Holy Spirit descended on King Saul and he began to prophesy to the point that the people in the town said, wait a minute, we didn't know Saul was a prophet. Is Saul also among the prophets? But he wasn't a prophet. But guess what? That anointing, the prophetic anointing of the Holy Spirit, rubbed off on his life just by association. Who is it that I'm preaching to tonight? I said, who is it that I'm preaching to tonight? Listen, you can receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost through a clot. Are you hearing me? The Bible says in Acts 19, I'm just flowing. The Bible says in Acts 19, the Apostle Paul preached with a mighty anointing of the Holy Spirit on him to the point that they said handkerchiefs and clots were taken from off of his body and placed on those who were demon possessed, those who were insane, those who were sick. And the Bible says the demons came out of them and the sick were completely healed. Think about it. If a handkerchief, my God, if God can anoint a piece of cloth, come on here, somebody. Don't you think the Holy Spirit is going to anoint me and you who are created in his image? We are saved. We are sanctified. We are washed in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't you think the Holy Spirit is going to anoint your life? Some of you are receiving an anointing right now. While you're on this live teleconference call, you're watching this broadcast through Periscope. As you are watching the same anointing that the Holy Ghost deposited in me and my wife's life, it's being imparted. No, we don't think we are nobody special. We are just ordinary people called to serve the people of God that tap into the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We don't think we're better than other people. No way, friend. It don't work like that. If you are truly anointed by the Holy Ghost, you would be humble because you realize that none of this stuff that's happening in your life is off you. It's Jesus. It's Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. It's the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Remember in Acts chapter 3, when the apostle Peter and John, the man who was paralyzed from his mother's womb, the Bible says he sat daily at the temple begging alms, begging for money. And the Bible says when Peter and John saw him, this man looked at them expecting to receive. You got to come with expectation. Don't be an ordinary Christian. You got to come looking for the Holy Ghost to jump on your life. You got to come looking for the anointing. The Bible says when he saw them, he looked at them expecting to receive something because there was something different about those men. I believe he sent something in his spirit. And the apostle Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I'm going to give it to you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the living God. Rise up and walk. And the Bible says Peter took him by the hand, and as soon as Peter touched him, the same anointing of the Holy Spirit that was in Peter's body flowed into that man, and the Bible says his ankle bones received strength, and he stood to his feet, and he went into the temple with the apostle Peter and John, walking, leaping, and praising God. And I'm sure he disrupted the whole service, because if it was me or you, we would have disrupted the whole service as well. So the healing anointing, the anointing of the Holy Spirit, can be transferred through touch. Peter touched him, and when he touched him, the anointing of the Holy Spirit flowed into that man's life and gave him a miracle. Remember the woman with the issue of blood? She said, man, I don't need him to lay hands on me. I got radical faith. I'm ready to take this thing to another level. If I can just touch the hem of his garments, I know, my God, I feel the Holy Ghost tonight. That the woman said, look, if I may just touch the hem of his garments, I know I'll be made whole. But wait a minute, where did she got this from? See, in the Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 19, the Bible says the whole multitude sought to touch Jesus, for there went power out of him and healed them all. She heard how other people grab onto the hem of his garments and it worked for them. She said, look, God ain't no respecter of persons. If it worked for them, I bet you do feel it. Listen, she said, if it worked for them, it's going to work for me. And she pressed her way through the crowd. And the Bible says she grabbed the hem of his garments. And as soon as she touched the hem of his garments, the Bible says immediately she felt in her body that she was made whole. And the Bible says Jesus turned around and said, wait a minute here. Somebody receive an impartation. Excuse me. Jesus said, somebody touch me. Peter said, someone touch you. He knew it because the Bible says he felt virtue went out of himself. He felt the power of God flow out of his body into that woman and made it well. Think about it. This woman tapped into the anointing by grabbing onto Jesus' garments. Oh my God. Are you hearing this? That's why we love listening to men and women of God. We love listening to worship music that's anointed. Are you hearing me? Because if it's anointed, it's going to saturate the atmosphere. It's going to keep you in the spirit. It's going to keep you sharp. It's going to keep you full of the Holy Ghost. Listen, another way to tap into the anointing is through worship. That's why when King Saul got around those men that were anointed musicians and prophets, that's why the Spirit of God descended on him. Because you can tap into the anointing of the Holy Ghost through worship. My God, are you listening to me? Listen, just lift your hands to heaven right now. Come on, just worship him right now. Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we love you with all of our hearts, our minds, our soul, our bodies, and our strength. We belong to you, Jesus. We love you, God. We thank you for the presence of God. We thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit, God. We receive that touch, God. We receive the anointing. Come on, somebody, receive. There's a flow happening here right now. You may be watching through your computer. You may be listening on the teleconference line. You may be watching through Periscope. Listen, friends, there's a flow of the anointing. Just lift your hands to heaven right now. Say, Lord Jesus, we love you. Lord Jesus, we love you. Lord Jesus, we love you. We honor you. We worship you. We adore you. We magnify you. We belong to you, Lord Jesus. We belong to you, our spirit, soul, and body. We belong to you, Jesus. Glory to God. Roko shata rababasata. Rabana rabasata. Roko tolobo shika rababasata. We bless you, God. My God, someone's receiving the anointing. Someone's receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Come on, saints. Just worship him for just a few more minutes. We receive that anointing. God, let an impartation take place to everyone listening. Everyone that's watching this live broadcast, let the presence of the Holy Spirit, let the presence of God, let the presence of Jesus, let it be made manifest. Let them feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit, God, being imparted into their lives, into their bodies, God. Anoint them. Anoint them for service in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, God. We love you, Master. Glory to God. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Excuse me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I feel the Holy Spirit. I feel the flow of the anointing. My God, my God. Come on, someone, just lift your hands to heaven and receive it. The Bible says when they dedicated Solomon's temple, the Bible says as the musicians begin to praise and worship God, the Bible says the cloud of his glory flood the temple to the point that the priest could not even stand to minister because the presence of God saturated the place. Do you see that? As soon as the music instruments begin to, as soon as they blew on the trumpets and all of the musical instruments begin to play, and as those musicians begin to worship the Lord God, the Bible says the glory of God appeared and was made manifest in the temple. That's why in some of our meetings, the presence of God, the sin so heavy that I can't even preach. All I could do is just lay before the pulpit. Why? Because it's not by power. It's not by might. It's by my spirit, says the Lord. It's not so much as hollering and shouting. That's my personality. When the anointing comes on me, I'm a shout. I'm going to dance. I'm a fall out in the Holy Ghost. Hello here, somebody. But listen to me, friends. In some of our meetings, the power of God comes down. People begin to weep. They begin to cry out to God. People get saved and miracles begin to happen. The blind begin to see. The deaf begin to hear. Cripples begin to walk. Cancer is cured under that anointing. AIDS, HIV, AIDS, completely cured by the anointing of the Holy Spirit. What a mighty God we serve. I'm in love with Jesus, man. Don't you love the presence of God? I said, don't you love the presence of God? So, back to our story here. The Bible says in 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 2, the Bible says, and Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, man. Stay here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said unto him, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. Wait a minute, friend. When you find that company where the anointing of God is flowing into your life and making a difference, one of the keys to receiving that anointing and maintaining it is to stay connected. So much times in the body of Christ, the devil will bring situations and before you know it, this person going east, the other person going west, and it doesn't benefit the kingdom of God. Are you hearing me? Elisha said, Elijah, you going to Bethel? God's telling you go to Bethel? God's telling me go to Bethel too. I'm hanging here, bro. I ain't letting you go. You ain't getting out of my sight. God's about to take you on out of here. I'm topping this anointing. I'm going to receive a double portion. I refuse to let you out of here. And listen, don't start thinking, ooh, we got to wait for a man of God to die. The devil is a liar. You can tap into that anointing of the Holy Ghost right now. Are you hearing me? The Bible says in Matthew 5, 6, he said, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Are you listening to me, friends? Verse 3 here in 2 Kings, the Bible says, and the sons of the prophets that were, I'm about to keep flowing here. And let me just say this. I want you to see this. In another place, Elijah, in another place, Gehazi, another servant of God, was working along with Elisha, the prophet. This after Elisha had tapped into the anointing and the woman's son had died. God didn't reveal it to Elisha. But finally, every time they ask her, what's going on? She said, it is well. My God, she wasn't a complainer. Her son was dead. And this woman refused to complain and whine. Elisha said, man, something's going on here. And God's not revealing it to me. Do you see that? As a prophet of God, you don't know everything. Only God knows everything. You only know what the Holy Ghost reveals to you. Don't let nobody scare you and make you think just because they come in your presence, they can know everything about you. Impossible. We are not God. We are human beings. Are you hearing me? I said, we are not God. Are you hearing me? But anyways, watch this. She finally told Elisha, she said, my son that you prophesied that God was going to give me, he is at home. He died. Elisha said, what? So watch what Elisha did, because what I'm trying to get you to see is the different ways you can tap into the anointing. Watch this. The Bible says Elisha took his staff. That's his stick. That's his stick, similar to what a shepherd would use. He gave it to Gehazi. Now watch this. Watch this. Because the same way you can receive the anointing, there are certain things you can do that would cause you lose the anointing. No, friend, we're not in the business of losing the anointing. What God give to us, we're going to keep it until the day God call us home. Now watch, Elisha gave specific instructions for Gehazi to follow if he was going to keep the anointing of the Holy Spirit in Elisha's staff. Elisha said, Gehazi, go to the woman's house and lay this staff on the dead boy, and he is going to come back to life. But then he said these words. He said, look, don't stop and talk with nobody on the way. Listen, before I preach, I don't even like talking with people. Now, on a day like today, I went to the hospital to visit a friend because his wife was in surgery. That's a little different story. They're very dead our hearts. So I went and take some time to be with them. Amen. But listen, Elisha told Gehazi, he said, don't talk with nobody on the way, man. The anointing is in this staff, and if you just sit and get around the wrong crowd, they're going to drain the anointing out, and when you get to this woman's dead son, nothing's going to happen. You'll be there by yourself. So Gehazi went. Now watch, I want you to see this. So Gehazi went, and the Bible says, Gehazi took the staff and placed it on the woman's dead son, and guess what? Nothing happened. I'll tell you why nothing happened. Because Gehazi stopped and ran his mouth and fooled around on his way to obeying what the man of God told him. And that same Gehazi later in his life ended up with leprosy and without the anointing. Are you listening to me? So if you're going to keep the anointing, You gotta be very careful with the friends you choose. You get around the wrong crowd, they will drain the Spirit of God off of you. They will grieve the Spirit of God off of you. That's why the Bible says, grieve not the Spirit of God. Don't grieve him. That word grieve right there means he can be hurt. He like as if you are giving him some type of pain. Are you hearing me? So that's why before I preach, especially if I'm going to preach a miracle service, ain't nobody going to see me that day except my wife and kids. Why? Because I'm on lockdown all day. Why? I'll go into prayer from 7, 8 in the morning, and I won't come out till 5 in the evening. Why? Because I know I can't work no miracles. I can't heal the sick. I can't cast devils out. I stay in the presence of God and as I worship God, that anointing thickens. The atmosphere in our room changes. The presence of God becomes real. Are you hearing me? That's when the word of God come alive. I may lay on the floor and weep or wherever, but the Spirit of God descends. That's when the word of God comes alive, and he would begin to show me the different kind of miracles that's going to happen even before we get there. Are you listening to me, friend? Are you listening to me? There's a price to pay to walk in the power of God. And when I get to that meeting, I don't sit there running my mouth, yapping with everybody. I'm off to the side meditating because I ain't come to have church as usual. I come to see God move. I ain't come to fool around. I want a move of the Holy Ghost. I want to shake this generation. I want to cast the devil out, heal the sick, raise the dead. We ain't got time to play church. Are you hearing me, friends? Is anyone receiving tonight? Are you listening to what I'm sharing with you? We ain't got time to play church. Listen, That's what we do. Whether it's me preaching or my wife, I would have to let her have the room so she can lock down and seek God. Listen, there's a price to pay to walk in the power of God. And prayer is another avenue to tap into the power of God. That's what we talked about last night. As Jesus was praying, the heavens was opened. And the Spirit of God descended, on him in the form of a dove. We serve a mighty God. Are you listening to me, friends? We serve a mighty God. I said we serve a mighty God. We're talking about receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Listen, absolutely, the anointing is costly. Salvation is free. But to walk in the power of God, it's going to cost you something. Are you hearing me? We want you guys anointed. And what I'm doing tonight, I'm pouring my heart out to you. Listen, when I first gave my heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, the first time the real anointing of the Holy Spirit began to descend on my life, I used to be the church drummer. This is in the Bahamas. And in one of the services, man, I tell you, the power, the presence of God came down in that church. And my pastor looked at me. My pastor's in heaven now. But he looked at me. He said, you know what? I want you to come lead this prayer. Man, I got up and began to pray. And whilst I was praying, electricity began to cover my hands. I didn't understand it back then, you see. It almost kind of shook me up. Because I'm an electrician. I understand what electricity is. Real electricity began to flow into my left hands. I thought, oh my God, what's happening? But I realized it was supernatural. Impartation started happening because my pastor, being a man of God, called me. He said, look, you know what? And we didn't even tap into the healing ministry. Listen to the words he said. He said, you know what? I feel a healing anointing here. I want you to come pray. You see that? So God was preparing me, God was preparing me even back then to walk into healing ministry. I didn't understand it. I'm just pouring my heart out to you. Is anyone enjoying this tonight? Is anyone receiving tonight? I said, is anybody receiving tonight? Talk back to me. Let me know. Praise God. Praise God. Is anyone being helped tonight? Listen, you don't have to be a superstar to be anointed. There are certain keys, and I'm trying to give you every key I ever know about. Are you hearing me? So one of the things that also helped me was my dad had a niece in the Bahamas. She's a powerful preacher. She is. Her name is Pastor Carolyn Cooper. Listen, I want you to hear me. I became her armor bearer. She's my first cousin. And that woman preached, she used to preach under the anointing and still does. And this woman would fast and she would pray all night, man. Us were around her team. Listen, this woman would pray from 10 at night till 6 in the morning. Are you hearing me? Is anybody here? She would pray from 10 at night until I thought, my God, I want what this woman have. So I became her armor bearer, Mike, and I became very close to her. I was her water boy. I would pour her water in church, carry her towels, whatever. Thank God she's my first cousin. Amen? So listen, and I served that woman faithfully. And as I stayed in her meetings, I would watch how she would preach. I would watch how she would lead the people into worship. And as she did, the presence of God would just flood the whole place out. People would begin to weep. They'd begin to cry. And God would begin to move. People would be touched. They would be delivered. They would be set free. And the more I served that woman of God and stayed around her, that same anointing rubbed off on my life until the day God called me to come from the Bahamas to America. So I tapped into the anointing through the obedient voice of my pastor, Reverend Lawrence Pinder, back in the Bahamas. He obeyed God. And because he obeyed God, I tapped into the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And then as my first cousin, Pastor Carolyn Cooper, as she obeyed God and poured into my life and helped mentor me, listen, don't be a know-it-all. You need somebody to teach you. Are you hearing me? I said, you need somebody. I know the Bible says the Holy Ghost will teach you all things, but listen, that does not mean that you're not going to need a teacher. That's why God have anointed a teacher in the body of Christ. Are you hearing me? Because you need somebody in your life to teach you, to mentor you, to show you the way. Because if you have a mentor, if you have someone in your life who know the way and who paid the price, it makes it so much easier for you, friends. Are you listening to me? You could be mentored through somebody's tapes. You could be mentored through somebody's books. There's a whole lot of different ways to tap into that anointing of the Holy Spirit. What we are after is we are after the anointing. Why are we so big on the anointing? This is why. Because Jesus said, we are big on it because Jesus laid a foundation that nobody can deny. Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord God, Luke 4:18, he said, the Spirit of the Lord God is on me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. So right there, Jesus was telling us, you can't do it without the Holy Spirit. You got to have that anointing of the Holy Ghost. And what confirms what Jesus said is Acts chapter 10, verse 38. The Bible says how God, listen, this is just flowing on my heart. I'm not preaching from the notes. This is something God called me to teach on. Acts chapter 10, verse 38 says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, because God was with him. Do you see how Jesus healed the sick? Do you see how he cast out devils? It was through the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And Jesus said, you shall receive power after the Holy Spirit has come on you. We're talking about receiving the anointing. Receiving the anointing. Receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit, because Jesus laid down a rule and a guideline that nobody can get around, to the point that when Jesus was about to descend back to heaven after he was crucified and had risen from the dead, he appeared to his apostles, and the Bible says he stayed with them 40 days and 40 nights. Watch this. He, even though they saw miracles when Jesus was with them, because they were working miracles using the authority of his name. But now Jesus said, look, I'm about to leave. Listen to what he tell them in Luke chapter 24, verse 49. He said, guys, tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. That word endued means to be covered with the anointing of the miracle working power of God. That word endued means dunamis, dynamite, miracle working power, miraculous power. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 2, they were all gathered in one place and they were on one accord. And the Bible says the Holy Spirit came as of the sound of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And the Bible says they all were filled with the Holy Ghost and spoke in other tongues as the Spirit of God gave utterance. The Bible also says they appeared on them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat. My God, are you listening to me? They tarried. They tarried for 10 days. And on the day when the day of Pentecost came, Jesus said, it's time. And he poured the Holy Ghost out on them. Because when Peter got up to preach, he said, guys, we are not drunk as you suppose. It's just what? The third watch or whatever it was in the day. Peter said, look, this is that was spoken by the prophet Joel. It shall come to pass in the last day, said God, I will pour out my Spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. On my handmaidens and on my servants, I'm going to pour out the Holy Ghost, and they're going to prophesy. Now wait, this is where we get messed up. This is where we mess up, because we looking for something to come out the ceiling. Wait, I'll tell you how the Holy Ghost is poured out. It comes through a man, friend. The Bible says, know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? You want that anointing to flow on you? Get around anointed people of God. Get around them. You ain't got to worship them because they're human beings. But do show honor. Do show respect. Are you listening to me, friends? Man, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I'm going to pray for you in just a minute. I'm going to jump ahead of myself here in 2 Kings. The Bible says Elijah, he was at the Jordan River, and Elisha was with him. Elijah took off his mantle and hit the Jordan River. And the Bible says, I feel the Holy Spirit. You're going to have to, give me 1 second. Let me pick up my towel there. Listen, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit here. I feel the anointing. I feel the presence of God. Someone's being anointed right now. God's wrapping the anointing of the Holy Spirit on somebody's body. I feel the anointing. Someone may be beginning to cry. That's the anointing of the Holy Spirit coming on you. The Bible says Elijah took his mantle. Elisha was with him. They stood before the Jordan River. My God, I feel the presence of God. They stood before the Jordan. Elijah took his mantle and he hit the Jordan River. And when he hit the Jordan River, it split wide open. My God, the Bible says Elijah and Elisha walked over on dry ground. And Elijah looked at Elisha and he said, "Man, what do you want from me, Elisha?" Elisha said, "I'm going to tell you what I want. I feel the Spirit of God. I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit right now. God, we worship you. Glory to God. We honor you, Lord Jesus. We honor you, Lord Jesus. We honor you, Lord Jesus. My God, my God, my God. My God, my God, my God. I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I said, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. My God, just worship him. Just worship him. Just worship him. Just open your mouth right now, right where you are. Just worship him. Just magnify him. Open your mouth. Lift your hands to heaven. Activated by faith. I said, activated by faith. Just begin to open your mouth. Begin to praise him right where you are. I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. My God, my God, my God. I said, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit. God, have mercy on us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, friends. Open your mouth and worship God right where you are. I feel the presence of God. I said, I feel the presence of God. I feel his presence right here. I feel his presence right here, right now. Come on, just lift your hands to heaven. Worship him. Magnify him. If you are listening on the teleconference line, come on, just open your mouth. Begin to worship him. Begin to magnify him. We serve an awesome God. I said, we serve an awesome God. We serve an awesome God. Just open your mouth. Begin to worship him. Begin to magnify him. Begin to let him know how much you love him right now. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I feel the anointing of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. God, touch your people right now. Let that anointing of the Holy Spirit, oh God, let it flow into their spirit, man. Fill them with the Holy Ghost to overflowing. Anoint them with the fire of God. Let it flow into their bodies, oh God. Let it flow into their bodies, oh God. Right now, receive an impartation. Receive an impartation right now. Receive an impartation right now. Right now in the name of Jesus. Receive a supernatural impartation. Receive it right now. Some of your lives about to be changed. I'm prophesying to you. Some of your lives about to be changed. Because when the anointing of the Holy Spirit comes on you, I don't care how weak you are, you become strong. I don't care how timid you are, you become bold. The Bible says the righteous are as bold as a lion. That's how David was able to defeat Goliath. It was because the anointing of the Holy Spirit came on him. That's how come Samson could take the jawbone of a donkey and wipe out 1,000 Philistines. He took out a whole army by himself. Why? Because of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. What about Gideon in Judges 6 and 7? He was timid when the angels appeared to Gideon. He said, "Man, I think you got the wrong guy." My God, that's because the man was not anointed. He was in his flesh. Without the Holy Ghost, you can't do nothing. Gideon thought the angel got the wrong man for the job. But I love what Judges chapter 6 verse 34 says. Judges 6 34 says, "And the Spirit of God came on Gideon." When the Spirit of God came on Gideon, he became as bold as a lion. And he delivered Israel out of the hand of the Midianites. It's not by power. It's not by might. It's by my Spirit. Samuel said to Saul, "The Spirit of God is going to descend on you. And you're going to be changed into another man." When that anointing comes, friend, Bondages are broken. Shackles are broken. Sickness leave. Diseases leave. Blindness have to go. Cancer has to die. Paralysis have to run from out of your body. HIV got to vanish out of your body. Because it's not by power. It's not by power. It's not by might. But it's by my spirit. It's by my spirit, says the Lord God. Just receive. Receive right now. In the name of Jesus. So right before God took Elijah up to heaven, Elijah looked at Elisha and he said, son, what do you want me to do for you before I leave? What is it that you want from me? What is it that you want? Elisha looked at him without any hesitation. He said, Elijah, I want a double portion of your spirit, that anointing that rests on your life. I want twice what you got. Elijah looked at Elisha and said, you've asked a hard thing. But if you see me right before I'm taken up, it's going to be yours. And the Bible says Elisha locked his eyes. He locked his eyes on Elijah. Because there's a place where you got to be refused to be distracted, because you're about to receive that anointing from the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says all of a sudden, the whirlwind happened. Horses and chariots of fire appeared. And Elijah went up to heaven by a whirlwind. And the Bible says Elisha saw it. And all of a sudden, that mantle flowed right down and fell at Elisha's feet. The Bible says Elisha reached out his hands and took it. Are you listening to this? You can take the anointing. Are you hearing me? You can reach out in faith and grab on to the anointing. And the Bible says Elisha took up the mantle of Elijah and he went back to the Jordan River. And he did not try to reinvent the wheel. Why change something that's working? You got to be nuts. Don't change it if it's working. He saw what worked. He saw what worked. He saw what worked for Elijah. And he said, I ain't changing nothing. If this is what that man of God is doing to tap into the anointing, I'm going to do the exact same thing. So Elisha walked to the Jordan River, took the mantle of Elijah, and he took it and he hit it. Wham! Guess what he said? Where, I feel the Holy Ghost here. He said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? And when he shouted and struck the waters, he did the exact same thing that Elijah did. Don't try to change what's working, friends. And when he hit the waters, the Bible says, the Jordan River opened up and Elisha walked over on dry land. That's a miracle. God gave them the same miracle that he gave Moses with the Red Sea and gave to Joshua when he was about to conquer Jericho. He did it for Elijah and he did it for Elisha. Are you hearing me? And the Bible says, when Elisha walked over the Jordan River, the other sons of the prophets that used to be around Elijah, when they saw Elisha walk through dry ground through the Jordan River, the Bible says they looked at Elisha and they said, truly the spirit of Elijah is now resting on Elisha. Are you listening to me? That means people are going to recognize when that anointing comes on your life, friends. Listen here, when you stand before people, man, I feel the spirit of God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Come on, saints. Just worship God with me for a few minutes here. We love you, Jesus. Oh, God, flow into the lives of your people. Flow into their bodies. Flow into their lives. Flow into their spirit, man, oh, God. God, we worship you. We honor you, Jesus. We adore you, God. We thank you, Jesus. Yes. My God, receive the anointing. You that's on the teleconference line, receive the anointing right now. You that's watching through Periscope, receive the anointing. You that's watching through your computers, receive the anointing right now. You that's watching this on YouTube or LinkedIn or Facebook or Twitter, receive the anointing right now. You may be on Pinterest watching this. Receive the anointing. The power of God is here. The Holy Spirit is here. Receive right now. Receive that impartation. Receive that impartation. Come on, lift your hands to heaven. I agree with you, sir. Come on, lift your hands to heaven. Say, Lord, I receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit right now. I receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I receive it right now. Come on, saints. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, receive. Come on, receive right now. Come on, receive, 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 receive. You that's on the teleconference line, come on, open your mouth and receive. Come on, receive, receive, receive. Ikarababasoto, rakatalabasande. In the name of Jesus, receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Receive it right now for signs, wonders, and miracles. Receive the anointing to flow in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. Receive the anointing. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. Receive it right now. Receive right now. In the name of Jesus. Receive right now. You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come on you. Receive right now, friends. Receive right now. In the name of Jesus. Jesus said, I will pray to the Father, and he will give you another comforter. I pray right now, in the name of Jesus, that you receive this impartation from the Holy Ghost by faith. Receive it right now. Lift your hands to heaven and receive it. Receive that anointing right now. God's filling someone with the Holy Ghost right now. We thank you, Holy Ghost. Receive right now. Receive that anointing. Receive it. Receive it. We impart the anointing of the Holy Ghost to you right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive that touch. Receive right now. Receive it right now. It belongs to you. You are a child of God. David said, he anointed my head with oil. When Samuel anointed David, the Bible says, the Spirit of God came on David from that day forward. We release the anointing of the Holy Ghost on your life. We release it. My God, joy has just come back into someone's life. God's restoring your joy. He's restoring your peace. It's not by power, friends. It's not by might. It's by my Spirit. It's by my Spirit, says the Lord. It's by my Spirit. Glory to God. Receive right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Receive. Receive. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive right now in the name of Jesus. Be touched, be healed, be delivered, be filled with the Holy Ghost and fire. Be filled with the Holy Ghost and fire. Receive the anointing of the Holy Ghost right now. Receive it right now in the name of Jesus. God bless you guys. We love you guys. We appreciate all of you. We appreciate all of you. What a mighty God we serve. I feel the presence of God here. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The Spirit of God is telling me, someone on this broadcast, you went to hell and back lately with the problems and the situations you've been dealing with. But God wants you to know tonight, he's turning your situation around. He's turning your situation around. He is turning your situation around. The Bible says, and we know that all things it work together for good to them that love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. Someone on this broadcast tonight, your situation is taking a turn for the better right now under this anointing of the Holy Ghost. Your situation is taking a turn right now. You may be watching this rebroadcast. Your situation is taking a turn for the better because the Bible says when the enemy comes against you like a flood, the Bible says, the Spirit of God will raise up a standard against him. He's working it together for good right now. He's working it together for good right now. Chains are being broken off some people's lives right now. Bondages are being broken. Addictions being broken. Being broken. The Bible says, and we serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty God. Receive the anointing. The devil's a liar. He's nervous. Praise God. Receive that anointing, friends. Receive that anointing. I'm sorry you that's on Periscope and maybe watching through your computers. We got kicked out for a minute there. Receive that anointing. That devil is a liar. He's shook up by the anointing of the Holy Spirit. The power of God shakes the gates of hell. The Bible says, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. The gates of hell. Apostle Mosley, tell Pastor Jan we love her, my brother. Praise God. Tell Pastor Jan we love her. God, we thank you. Listen, friends on Periscope, and that's on the teleconference line, I want you to join your faith with me. Pastor Jan had surgery today. I just want you to join your faith with me for a second. Let's pray for her husband who's watching this broadcast. Apostle Mosley, type back to me, my brother. I know you're watching this right now. I just want to pray for Pastor Jan. I don't know if she's looking at this. Is she looking at this, Apostle Mosley? Because we all want to join our faith and pray over her right now. Praise God. Praise God. Apostle, is she watching this? Come on, join your faith with me. Let's pray for Pastor Jan. Father God, we release the healing anointing of the Holy Spirit in Pastor Jan's life, in her body right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke the spirit of infirmity. We thank you, God. We thank you for your touch. We thank you that your word says, you were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon you. And with your stripes, we are healed in the name of Jesus. We cover Pastor Jan. We cover her in the blood of Jesus. We cover her in the healing power of God. We cover her under the anointing of the Spirit of God. It's not by power. It's not by might, but it's by my Spirit, God. We thank you, God. We thank you for a safe surgery today. We thank you for it, God. God, let her recovery happen supernaturally in the name of Jesus. We thank you for Pastor Jan. We give you praise for her, God. We give you glory for Pastor Jan and Apostle Mosley. God bless them beyond measure. No weapon that's formed against him will be able to prosper. And every tongue that rises up against him in judgment, we condemn it. I just want to pray for everyone on here. The Holy Spirit spoke to me and showed me some of you guys been up under severe attacks. Listen, the Spirit of God is raising a standard against those attacks right now. You've been attacked in lots of different ways, in your marriage, in your finances, in your body, in your relationship with people, on your jobs, in your business. I pray for those areas in your life. I bind the devil. I bind you, Satan. I bind you in the name of Jesus. Loose the people of God. Take your hands off. We take up the shield of faith and we quench every fiery dart. We quench every fiery dart of the enemy right now. We quench every fiery dart. We quench every fiery dart. We quench every fiery dart right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We quench it. 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 Every fiery dot, we quench it. We quench it right now. In the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth on the teleconference line. Come on, open your mouth. We quench every fiery dot right now. We quench every fiery dot right now. Come on, pray with me, saints. We quench every fiery dot that's a sign from the devil against your life to frustrate you, to cause you pain, to hurt you, to cause you to suffer from heartbreak, to cause you to suffer disappointment. We break it. We break those attacks. We break those attacks. We break it right now in the name of Jesus. We bind every foul and unclean spirit that's coming against your life. We bind it. We bind it. In the name of Jesus, every foul and unclean spirit, we bind you. In the name of Jesus, every attack from hell, we cancel it right now. In the name of Jesus, God, we cancel it. We cancel it, God. We cancel it. We call it null and void. In the mighty name of Jesus, what the devil means for evil, God, you are causing it to work together for good right now. In the name of Jesus, we cancel those attacks. We cancel it. We cancel it. We cancel it. We cancel it. We break the attacks of the enemy. We break the attacks of the enemy. Satan comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I've come that you can have life, that you can have it more abundantly. We thank you, God, for breakthroughs. We thank you for miracles. We thank you for signs. We thank you for oneness. We thank you for turning the situation around in the lives of your people. We thank you for doing it right now, God. Right now, God. Right now, God. Right now, God. Breakthroughs. Breakthroughs. Breakthroughs in every aspect of our lives. We claim it, God. We claim miracles. We claim healing for our body. We claim it in the name of Jesus. We claim it, God. We claim healing for our body. We claim breakthroughs in the area of our finances, God. Right now. I curse the wilderness. I curse the dry season. I rebuke the spirit of famine. I rebuke it. In fact, for somebody, I heard these words. The famine is over. Jesus is Lord. The famine is over for someone watching me right now. Your famine is absolutely over. The Holy Spirit told me to say to you, that chapter in your life of famine, he just closed that chapter in your life. The famine is over. That windows of heaven are opening over your life. It's about to be a flood. I say it's about to be a flood of the blessings of God. The Bible says these blessings will come on you and overtake you, but it's only coming because of Jesus and what he did on the cross for our lives and for our sins. We thank you for forgiveness. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for keeping us. I feel the presence of God. Who can feel a sweet anointing right here? Can you feel a sweet anointing? Can you feel a sweet anointing? God's turning it around. I say, God's turning it around. Glory to God. He's turning it around. You that's on Periscope, you that's on the teleconference line, God's turning it around right now. He's turning it around. He's turning it. He's turning it right now. He's turning it around. Oh, God, we thank you. Oh, God, we thank you. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. My God, he's turning it around. He's turning it around. I feel the presence of God. He's turning it around, saints. He's turning it around. He's turning it around. He's turning it around. He's turning it around right now. He's turning it around. My God, my God, my God. He's turning it around. He's turning it around right now. He's turning it around. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We honor you, God. We honor you, God. We honor you. We honor you. We honor you. We honor you. We honor you, God. And we promise, we make a vow, we won't touch the glory. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. Thank you, God, for what you've done, what you've accomplished on tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you guys. We love you guys. We love you guys. I said we love you guys. God bless all of you that was on the teleconference line. We love you guys. We love you guys. We appreciate y'all. Y'all continue to be blessed, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Keep on the whole armor of God. Stay in the anointing. Stay plugged into it. Stay plugged into it. Stay plugged into it. If God's using the teleconference call or through Periscope to bless you, stay connected to it. That's the key. Stay connected. Watch the replays. Go to our YouTube channel. Watch it over and over again. And as you do, you would be bathed in the anointing of the Holy Spirit. You would be bathed in the anointing. And then it becomes yours. And then you would begin to walk in it. You would begin to flow in the gifts of the Holy Ghost. You would begin to move in the things of God. That's the secret. Stay around the anointing. Stay around it. And as you stay around the anointing, revelation knowledge will increase from the written word of God. Your understanding will begin to be open. You'd begin to understand things that you didn't understand before. The gifts of the Spirit of God will begin to manifest itself in your life on a greater level. God bless you guys. We love all of you. We love all of you. Y'all take care. God bless you. We love you guys. We love you guys that's watching us on Periscope. Love all of you. You guys take care. I don't know if I'm going to be on here tomorrow. I may take a break tomorrow. But we'll see what the Holy Ghost does. We love all of you guys. We appreciate you guys. We appreciate you so much. Thank you for making this broadcast good, because without you, I mean, what's the use, you know? I'm not going to sit here and talk to myself, you know? So you guys are making this broadcast successful. Share it with your friends and your family members. Tell them about it. Say, look, Pastor Sean's on Periscope. God's using it to be a blessing to our lives, to speak the word into our lives. You need to listen to it. You need to check it out. Spread the word, because I'm believing God to have 1 million people on here with us. Amen? God bless you guys. Love you guys. Y'all take care. Enjoy the anointing. Apply yourself to it. Apply yourself. God's going to do powerful things in you guys' lives. God bless you. Walk in victory. God bless you. Awesome. Bye-bye.